like it's going to be a Walker's Rundown coming up here next. We got some order established, hopefully.
Ladies and gentlemen of Steamboat Days, welcome to Walker's Rundown. It is my esteemed pleasure to greet you all. Thank you. Thank you for attending. I know the reason you're here. I also know that back there, where all the sweaty men are, we've got one guy that, well, he grew up with you. He can be described in one word. However, there's children in the audience, so I can't really give that word. So, without further ado, Jake, what's his name again?
Jake Classic.
Jake Classic, that's it.
Jake Classic. Yep, not to be confused with Jack Classic. Jake Classic, a native of Winona, Minnesota, making his way out here. The winner of the Straight to the Top tournament. He's got a golden opportunity in Cashman, Wisconsin, July the 14th to take on Superstar Steve Stardom. But here tonight, though, he's got Jason Masters and that title. That briefcase is going to be on the line. Jake Classic been on a tear here in Seven Rivers Wrestling. There has never been an uncrowned champion before. It was Jake Classic.
I'm giving you jiggle time. Take it.
Jake Classic shaking his moneymaker for all the ladies in the crowd.
All right, sir. So when you wrestled on that side of the river not too long ago, you climbed a ladder, you took a briefcase away from the Ross family, and that means what?
That means that I get a shot at the heavyweight title of Seven Rivers Wrestling.
Whenever you want, right?
Whenever I want.
So what the hell are you waiting for?
What do you mean, what am I waiting for?
What are you waiting for? I believe...
I can take any time I want.
Anytime you want. So, why don't you call the guy...
Right now, I can do it tomorrow, the next day, next week. It doesn't matter.
But you haven't done it yet, have you?
No, I haven't done it yet.
And why? Because you're afraid of Superstar Steve Stardom.
Oh, I'm not afraid of anybody.
Oh, I think you are, because there's a reason why you haven't gone for the title yet. There's a man that's wearing it that you know would kill you.
I beg to differ. I think I could take the champion, Superstar Steve Stardom, any day of the week.
Come on now. That's tough talk.
Well, that's Superstar Steve Stardom's
music. I guess maybe we'll get the answer to that question.
Well, it looks like he's going to rudely interrupt Walker's Rundown.
Ladies and gentlemen, rise to your feet, put your hands together, and show some damn respect.
Steve Stardom should be fined and suspended for what he did to our backstage announcer, Nick Ragnar, and I even 8 days ago. Kyle drove the young kid right in his head. God. Oh, I know, man. You got your business in that ring. God, what a jerk.
Hello, sir.
Thanks for the save with that light kit. A little windy out here.
That's right.
Now, sir,
business
if I'm not mistaken, just so that we can educate the dumb ones in the crowd, what's this thing around your shoulders here?
Well, let's see. Let me count here for a second. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, wait. I've held about 20 of these. Yeah. This is the 20th one I've held in 20 years. Yeah, you know, you lose count after a while.
but you remember you know. How many?
Of course, none of you would know what the heck that's all about. A bunch of losers that you are. 5 to 9 jobs that you have. Nothing. But, hardworking, right, yeah. Their IQs match their shoe size. Now, Classic, you come out here shooting your big mouth off. You already had your opportunity in this stinking town once, all right? The only good thing I can say about this city is that I'm undefeated here. Nobody's ever beaten me in this city.
Nobody ever will.
That's right, nowhere. So you can come out here and you can run those bicycle pedal-sized lips of yours, Classic, all you want.
That's a little rude.
The fact of the matter is, you know, I don't care about Money in the Bank. I don't care about first contender matches. I don't care about none of that. All right? As far as I'm concerned, Classic, you blew your opportunity the first time here.
I earned another opportunity.
You earned nothing. All right? All you earn is to keep your mouth shut. All right? Because I'll dictate who I get in the ring with and who I defend this against.
Yeah, it's kind of a championship committee, though. Well, there, that's the lumberjack. Who's actually the number one contender, don't it?
It only gets better, huh?
You won a fatal four-way match last week in Winona.
Excuse me. The last time I checked, my name's on this show. What the hell are you doing here?
I'd like to know myself. What are you doing out here?
You know, Mr. Stardom, I think you forgot one thing, and you too, Jake Classic. I believe me and you have a match tonight for that heavyweight title that I'll be taking home with me.
You'll be another loser, Lumberjack.
Really? You're going to waste your time with this guy?
No, what happens is the promoters waste their time in putting inferior competition in the ring with me. But that's okay. You know, you can come out here, you can challenge, you can have all the matches you want, Lumberjack, all right?
Wait a minute. Okay, so wait a minute. So you're supposed to wrestle him tonight, right?
Yep.
But you think you deserve this, right? So how about the three of you do a street dance for me tonight?
It's a street fight, not a street dance.
Old-fashioned wrestling.
No. Hold it. First of all, you jackass, you want to stand there and tell me that you're going to come and get this anytime you want? I'm going to tell you something. Right here standing in front of you is what's going to keep you from getting this. All right? And as far as you're concerned, Lumberjack, they already told me in the back they're making our match a street fight. So if you want to fight me or wrestle me or whatever you want to do to try to get this from me, go ahead, because here I am. You just get the hell back and don't get
like
my
GM
face.
GM Vic Ross is actually getting to the ring. Thank God someone's actually going to get done with this.
Hang on a damn minute. I make the matches around here, not you, and especially not you. Now the bottom line is, you two tonight in a street fight, but it ain't going down right now, and this long-haired freak ain't in it. You, I'm talking to you, because you, sir, as it was alluded to by Steve Stardom, have something that belongs to the Ross family.
What would that be?
The number one spot, brother. So tonight, you're gonna put that on the line against my man, Jason Masters.
Oh, bring him on out, please.
In time.
Well, that's going to be definitely a great match.
Mr. Stardom, you know I respect you, but I got to ask you to please not put the boots to this chump until the main event. There's a lot of money on the stake, man. Please.
Vic Ross doing the right thing, breaking up this confrontation in the middle of the ring. We got some big matches set up.
You want him to mind his place? Hey, if you want a title match tonight, get out of my ring right now.
Well, we heard it. Lumberjack and Stardom. The title is on the line. Street fight rules here in Steamboat Days.
Looks like somebody ain't getting paid tonight.
Well, it looked like Walker got a little bit in the rundown on that one. Well, folks, up next, though, we got ourselves. Wait. I got some breaking news. We gotta go to the commercial break, but we're going to be back with Chris Grubb backstage. He's trying to get us another word with Vic the Stick Ross. Are you all right there? Here. Here's some water.